Hi everyone, my name is Didi. Welcome to part 5 of Operation Waffentrager. In this series, I am charting my path. I'm not going to call it success, because that's a little bit... we've not got there yet. But I'm charting my journey, shall I say, up through the German tank destroyer line, up into the beast. That is the Waffentrager Alf E-100. Probably pronounced it very badly. Let me know, and I'll try and find... if I am pronouncing it very badly, I'll try and find a better way of pronouncing it. But here I am. The first few episodes, I managed to get through the Marder 38T. Managed to ace it towards the end of that. And now I am on this flak bus. This beast. I'm not sure really it's a beast, to be honest. I'm going to call it a thing. This toaster. This whatever it is. Played a few games. I've played about 10 games so far. Actually, let me just show you the stats. Let's see how I've been getting on with it. There we go. Yeah, I have played 10 games. 6 victories. Quite pleased with that. 9 enemies destroyed. I have been over-exuberant in my energies at trying to get to... to shoot some tanks and got killed very early on in a couple of games. So, yeah, need to kind of pause on that. But it's not too bad. 60% win rate is okay. I've still got this 7.5mm flak L60 on there. 139 pen, 135 damage. It's okay. It's not great. I am quite pleased with it. This next iteration, the 8.8 flak 37 L56... is my dream, because it has 220 average damage. Bonkers. It reloads slower, sadly. As you can see there, it does 8.82 rounds per minute as opposed to the 7.5, which is 15. However, that damage is I can't wait. There is also the next iteration, 194 pen, 240 damage, but I don't think I'll get there or unlock it by virtue of the fact that the Nashorn is the next in line on the journey up to the Alf E100. Therefore, I might unfortunately have to skip it. But I only have 1,174 experience left until I can unlock that 8.8 centimeter cannon, gun, whatever you want to call it, beast. The 88, the famous, infamous, probably a better way of describing it, infamous 88mm anti-aircraft gun that was used by the Germans in the Second World War to great effect at knocking out tanks. So, what else do I need to think about? I need to think about what is going to give me the best amount of experience and therefore... how can I, as quickly as possible, get myself up to that Alf E100? So I'm going to pick all of the... Oh no, I can't choose that one because I'm not actually going to use any of those vehicles. I'm going to pick the... destroy 2 or more? Or damage 3 or more? Let's go for damage. Yeah, going to pick the ones that's going to give me experience so I can level up as quickly as possible. And with that said, this is the first game, episode 5. I've got my double XB to have a look at. Hopefully, it's going to be a good one. But let's find out. So we're playing on Kamarin. In what looks like an absolute beast of a game. I am bottom on tier 5 on my team. Literally the scout tanks are better than me. There is a whole load of tier 7s. 4, 5, 9 I think tier 7s. Things... I do like this map, to be honest. I think it's quite good. But I have my concerns. We seem to have way too many tank destroyers on our side as well. We've got 7 tank destroyers on our team as opposed to their 4. What we don't have in tank destroyers They've made up for... Oh, my. I didn't even know I was spotted. Right, this is awful. Awful, awful. I'm going to have to play so carefully now. Get through the puddle. If this AMX doesn't try to take me out, I'll be stunned. No, get away. That's fine. Fine. I got some damage in. Damage is good. Got a crit. I probably am spotted right now. So I am just gonna wait down here in this little undulation until I feel a bit better about the world. Maybe I can get a shot on that M4. No, he's gone away. It's fine. Got to be very wary he's there though. See if I can snipe over the top of this, which I can. I'm unspotted. Let's get out of here. Ooh, see? These guys up here are going to be the bane of my life. For this game anyway. Long old game. Creep forward, creep back. Poke people when I can. Trapped him. Come on, come on, chaps. There's no artillery to worry about, which is one good thing. I'm gonna take out that AMX because he is big annoying. That's my opposite number. I missed him. Seriously, they've taken out everyone around me. I should have paid more attention to the minimap. Although, to be fair, this guy, the Yag Panther, I'm really not sure what he's doing, to be honest. If I can get blown up. Extremely unsuccessful. I hope we lose it because obviously I don't want to get the double for this game. Well, okay. There's a lot of tanks sat up on this ridgeline waiting for some poor unsuspecting scouts and whoever's to turn up. I think they're going to quickly get surrounded though, at this rate. The scores are 5 and 9. 6 and 9. So at this point, I'll just thank you all for those who are watching, and thank you to those that have left comments around their experiences with the flak burst and the Marder 38 in the previous episodes. That was... It's good to read. Good to read how you feel about certain tanks and from the different nationals. The different tanks that each nation has. If you've got any kind of comments or suggestions or see me do something really stupid, please let me know. I'm sure there's some tactical masters out there who are like giving some ideas on spots. I am not the world's most amazing tank, world of tanks player. I don't think I'm bad. I think I'm pretty good. But I haven't got a huge amount to compare it with, to be honest. So you'll have to tell me. Yeah, things ain't looking too good. Equally, if you want to see me do another playthrough on a different nation, a different type of playthrough, like maybe a scout playthrough or a heavy tank playthrough, give me a shout out on that. Let me know. This is, that's the tier 5, isn't it? 7 even. This is my destiny. I think that's the Emil, I think. Absolute beast of a thing. Look at the size of that gun! Okay, there it was. And finally, the poor 88 is down.
We may have lost this one, but we'll be back.
Gutted. How much experience do I get for that? 154. Wow. Okay, that's not my worst ever game. There's actually two other games that I got less than that. But it's pretty much up there, to be honest. And it looks like I am pretty much one of the worst players. Oh well. Gotta move on, next battle. Sand River at night. Again, we have six tank destroyers on our team. Tier 5s, few tier 7s, one tier 4 Stuart on theirs. This looks a bit more balanced. There's not so many tier 7s. I'm still literally at the bottom of the rung as such. I'm going to try and stay reasonably... Come on. No! Why did I reload when I did? It seems like most of my bros have kind of gone forward. Nice. T29 is an amazing tank. Me and this guy are an artillery, absolute juicy target, but there is no artillery, so that is ideal. He's doing.
Bounced off. We didn't even scratch them.
Missed. Come on, get some shots in.
We need yes.
One down. We got two people in the cap though. This is tactically we're looking a bit rubbish. I want to go and support that guy over there, but... Should we do it, guys? Should we go over there? I think there's a few people scouting over there. Hellcat's getting owned. Let's go. We've got to support the 87 over there. That's it, yeah. 40 seconds. Come on, someone get some shots in on the base. Reset the cap. This is another absolute fail. Come on, someone shoot the cap. Someone shoot the cap. Seriously, someone shoot the cap. 10, 9, 8, 6, 5. Flipping it. Oh my days. Unbelievable.
Nothing more we can do here.
Oh, why did that 87 just move forward like 5 yards? And he would have actually, you know, he could have actually helped. So frustrating, so frustrating. Next game. Okay, so we're on highway. It's another encounter battle. So we've got again the capture zone just tucked underneath that bridge in the railway line, which is a difficult place to cap. And we have a bit more of a healthy, should I say healthy, a bit more of an even skill set, as there's a lot of tier 6s this time. Fair amount of tier 5s and a few tier 4s. No tier 7s to worry about. I'm not going to accelerate away. If I feel that cap is going to come under a lot of pressure, I'm obviously going to get over there as soon as I can. I think I might just see how the map develops and where tanks start appearing and move myself into some good positions. Like that. So there's one heavy over there, two heavies over there. Let's get ourselves into the firing, get ourselves into the game. This is what it's all about. Use that cheeky monkey. Oh, missed. Get out of the way.
Critical hit.
Come on, Churchill. Gonna shoot everything I see, really. Just gonna go for the Confederate.
We didn't even scratch them. Critical hit.
Great position, great position. Excellent spotting by my teammates.
That's gotta hurt. Yeah,
tracked him, see if I can get the low glacier.
We nailed him back.
So I do want to shoot that anymore. Tank down. Two over there in their camp. In our cap three. Well, I'm going to get over there because I don't want to lose this game again exactly the same way I did before. I mean, it is ridiculous. Not this position, I didn't mean that. My men. Where's defend the base? There isn't a defend the base. Why isn't there a defend the base? There it is. I'm going blind. Right, I think there's a really good firing line if I can get myself right down to this corner. As long as my teammates don't suicide themselves, I think I'm on to a winner. If I can get there in time. And there's only one in the cap at the moment. So that is going to be good. Let's leave this firing line down into... I think we're in the railway line. Spot them for me, bro. Spot them. The KV-2 is basically the biggest target in history. It's Churchill. There we go. Hello. Where did that go? Should have led the shot a little bit. I didn't need to miss that one. Wolverine? How did you just ding that? That Wolverine is massively optimistic. And so is this. They're all just laying themselves to play for me. Do not. How did he spot me? No, I mean, I'm not in cover, I just can't.
We nailed them bad. We didn't penetrate their
armor. You're joking me.
Enemy armor is destroyed.
Alright, sweet. 3 kills. That's really evened the game up massively. Is that Hetzer I just saw? I think it said Hetzer, didn't it? Yeah. So I've not come across that, bro. I don't know what that is. Okay, now we'll just take one more. What are they left with? That Nashor, the T1 Heavy and the Hetzer. No idea where the T1 Heavy is. I think I'm just going to go YOLO it, to be honest. Because a KV-2 is going to attract a lot of attention. As is the VK1, there's the heavy, there's the green. Yeah. If I can get some shots in here just by chasing them down, I will. It seems we've pretty much won this one. I'm gonna go assault tank with the flak bus. Ooh, if I get shot in there. Hello?
We nailed him back!
No, come on. 4th kill. Let's give it an excellent first double point win. of the day, whatever you call it. First win of the day, double score. Excellent. Maybe I can pick up the fifth kill if we get this T1 heavy out of the way. I'm not really sure where he's got to. Might just go for a flying visit.
No.
Did he spot me? He must have spotted me, really, didn't he? Okay, that's a bit more spotting points. More spotty bonus. There it goes.
Great job, man!
Yes, victory! How many XP is that? 1,328. Doubled up, 2,656. Mega awesome. First rate. If I'd have been just a cheekily bit more aggressive and maybe gone for that T1 heavy at the end there, there could have been a chance that I could have got that ace tanker, but plenty more time for that, and there's plenty more time for that because I've still got a long way to go with this tank. Good news though is that is going to get me this 8.8. How's it looking? I am annoying. Ooh, it's a bit bigger. That's looking nice. Have I got to change ammo? Yes, I do. I'll take 5 rounds of that. I'll take 10 primos, I think. Does that look about right? I'm going to just take a bit more primo, because I seem to be coming up against quite a lot of rude boy tanks. I have got the gun rammer, I've got a camo now, I really want the binos, but I obviously don't have anywhere near enough money, which is a shame. Let's see, what operations, have I done all the operations yet? No, I've got a few more of those to go, that's fine. Right then, next battle. So here we are on Mountain Pass. It seems to be a counter is the game of the day. Now, this proves... this can be problematic then. I'm not sure.
Let's go.
I think I'm going to sit myself here and then maybe work around there, depending on what's going on. It's sometimes good to be able to shoot across the lake. Obviously, with the catch point being in the middle, people are going to go for that. I could work my way around to the left though. That's going to inherently put me in danger. So I've kind of got to see where everybody else goes. See who's going to spot for me, who's not. So I'll let these guys go ahead. Who's that? A knight? I've never even heard of a knight before. I have to live up. Sit at the back. Maybe. Push. Push is being hugged. There's a lot of tanks over there. If we're not careful, they're going to rat around this corner. Oh yeah. That's another knight. They've got a knight as well. Is this a new tank? I don't know about. Missed, didn't it? That's a rubbish shot. It looks like a... oh dear. It looks like a Cromwell to me, but... I don't know. Let's have a look. It's going to be a game of patience by the looks of it. In fact, I might actually forego the patience and follow these bros around here and give them some support. We may end up doing like a complete spin around the edge of the map. They completely flank us to the right, we completely flank us to them to the left. Let's see what happens. Although, is that guy down in the basin? Down in the basin, which it is, then I'm going to get him. Coming up, there you go.
Critical hit!
Oh, 222 damage. Insane.
Bounced off!
Bounced. I might forget about him and go for this punk. He's getting a bit easier target.
200!
Oh, this gun is sexy. How can you have a sexy gun when it looks like that? Oh, yeah. Uh-oh. Who spotted me? Who spotted me there? Killed everybody. Blimey. Nearly got one in the teeth. Alright, let's carry on with the original plan. That's a lot of damage. I just did about, man, it's four. About 600-700 damage there, three shots. Alright. The flak bus has teeth. Well, I don't really want to stand here and trade, but. Excuse me, don't. Spotters? No. Oh, he's not going to come forward, is he? Oh, there's something up there. Type 58 up there. Can I get shot on? Goes around the edge. See if my fellow's just wrecked out his cover. Yes, this pet is penning constantly. This gun is sweet as. Oh, 248 damage. In your face. As predicted, they've kind of like, we've gone our way, they've gone theirs. This is going to be my kill.
He's gone. See you later,
alligator. Oh, hello. Come on, take your arm up. Let's see if I can't get this M4.
Gotcha.
Victory. This gun is good, guys. Seriously nice gun. 1-1-1. Awesome gun. Gonna enjoy this, gonna go straight on to the next battle. In this next battle, we are at Fisherman's Bay. And it's a war. It's a war at Fisherman's Bay. In the PC version, it spawns up here. And down here. I think it's good if you're a heavy tank because you can just come along there, but I'm not really. I don't know what to do with myself as a tank destroyer. Other than go to the places where I know I like to go in the PC version, which is. It's not really going to work, is it? Because I won't have any of my friends. Come and help me. Excuse me, sorry. Come on, Chai, you can do it. Go on. Oh man, this is brilliant. Yeah, I'm not going to follow you on that. Which is fine. Tank traps. Ooh, tank traps there as well. Who left those tank traps there? Really? Come on. So my thoughts are, working away on this ridge line over here, means I can push forward. I can cut down areas of the map where enemies can and can't be. Therefore, I can effectively control my firing arc. What I mean by that is if I come down here and I manage to push the way out here to there, that means I know that people aren't going to be behind me or in front of me. They're all going to be in front of me so I can aim where I should be aiming. 82's armour is always.
Didn't penetrate their
This is what I want, though. If I can hit it. Stop moving. Whoa, someone just absolutely nailed him. I think that was the other flak bust that did that.
We didn't penetrate their armor.
Bounced again. And he's down. Oh well, I'm not hitting anything. Which is a bit rubbish, but there you go. Yeah, well, this is what I'm talking about. We got flanked. Big time. So we should get up onto the higher ground there is the right. Now this crusader do the spotting for me. Turn 4 is gonna eat it. It's totally eaten.
The
track
is damaged.
Go, flakbus, go, flakbus. Agile, weave like a snake in a desert. To be honest, with 9 and 1, this is like absolute obscene. Absolutely. Front oh, one shot it. I think some of my water hit, to be honest, and my shell came slightly behind, but even so, that was a pretty satisfying kill. I wonder if we weeded those guys out of there, unless someone pops up, so I can get my eye on that. To the right, to the left. Some targets when we can. No, we haven't picked them up. Let's go and pick out this Panzer IV. He's the one that's likely to come up behind me and say hello to me in a lovely way.
Ready to fire on target.
Help, I can take it. Oh, not if I miss like that. Oh, let's dance then, my friend. Let's dance. Oh no, don't turn that way. Oh, you missed.
He's gone. Find us another target.
It does that sometimes in the console. I don't know why. You're turning to the left, but it just turns you to the right. I better be. It's me or what, but. I don't know.
Great job, man.
Excellent, another victory. Got to be happy about that. I forgot to look how much damage I did last time. Because it would have been in quite a lot. So actually, you know what? I'm just going to go and quickly look how much damage I did. In the old log. In the classic log. Not that one. It's that one. It's detailed report. 1,193 damage. That's not bad. I'm looking to fourth. That's okay. So I'm going to optimistically look, see how much I've got left till I get the last one. 22,600. Got to keep cracking through these games. Okay, so we're back on highway, and it's another encounter battle, and this time it is tier 5 frenzy. And I guess for me the question is, do I even bother to go down that way, or should I secure the cap?
Let's go.
Last time I got here, I got spotted really easily, and then got I could get seriously owned. Whoa, chill, brother, chill. If we go on our own. However, it is like Task Force. No. Task Force. Everybody capture the flag. Right now, look at it. We've got KB1, Stug, 2 Churchills, what's that, BK1H, everybody, I want everybody, is well up for coming and taking this flag. So this, to me, is going to be a quick game. Nothing wrong with that. Cleared by Frenzy. Look at everybody, apart from him, who's that T1 Heavy, he's like, oh, I'm going to go on my own way, cheers, see you later, thanks guys, thanks for the help. Mad. Join the herd, my friends. don't be a loner. You're gonna get picked off by the wolves. I reckon I can camp somewhere right back in. Let's just try and leave this tree standing if I can. Yes. There's a little camper on the edge of the map. It's me. It's me. My bush. Got my stove. Hopefully if they come over that way, I should generally have a whale of a time. I think it's, well, there's that bush there where that stoop's next to, but that's where I got spotted last time. So I think that's a bit too close for a very lightly armoured flak bus that I'm in. Having said that, they're already on the cap, so that KB1 is... I'm just going to wait, actually, I'm just going to wait till these guys are going to get a bit closer. So I know there's no one lurking around here or similar. What's he shooting at? Right. Spotted them. Yeah, see? See? You cheeky little T, what have you. Glitching on the old head there.
We didn't penetrate their armor.
Come on, no. So frustrating. Oh, come on. Oh, he's going to get down. So I'm not using premium rounds, eh? I do think we're going to get flanked to the right quite heavily in a minute, but I should be able to spot them, and I'm surely kind of tucked out of the way just to avoid any danger, but if we're not careful... Chai, the T-man is asking for trouble. Nothing. Absolutely nothing for it. Honestly, they're both just juking it out, trying to get going. Come on, lure them over, lure them over. I'm definitely not moving. I've got my sleeping bag out and everything. Churchill sat up there, seriously, bro. You're like a ridiculous target. Put some shots on somehow. I need to go, I need to move. Let's move around with my compadres. It's like a tank graveyard. Oh, ridiculous. Oh, hello.
That's gotta hurt.
I'm spotted, I think.
We nailed them bad.
That was a bit annoying. If I'd stayed there, would it make a difference? Yeah, probably. I should have stayed where I was. Mistakes were made. Mistakes were definitely made. If I'd have stayed where I was, I was probably could have helped out my bros not get flanked quite so hard, because I could have shot them. Actually, that guy's pretty close to it. He would have spotted me, really. I was back there. Is first solo one-man KV-1 mission.
We may have lost this one, but we'll be back.
Ramboing his way to victory. Or not. I think I did really badly there. Yeah, 138. Really badly. That's my lowest score of this session. I think I'm going to play one more game. And then, we'll leave it there. So the final battle of the episode is on Corellia. It is a standard battle. Lots of tier 5s, a few tier 4s. They've got two artillery, so I need to be really careful. I'm going to do the standard thing, a tank destroyer does, get myself into a nice push. In this case it's here. And I'm really not going to move until I can work out where everybody's going. And who is where, and that scout is going for a scout suicide by the looks of it, so let's get prepared to take advantage of that. Go scout suicide, are you so far away that you're not in radio range anymore? Yes, you are. Excellent. Which really is a suicide though. Come back! All is forgiven. One scout death. Oh, I can see someone, That was a miss. This range is so difficult to judge. Doesn't look very good over on that side. Yes! That's literally almost one side of the map to the other. Missed that one. Okay, there's look at down here. This is like an absolute car park of enemy tanks. Go and open up. See if I can't get on this ridge line. In distance. You can be so pretty assured that these guys are going to get taken down. In my humble opinion. On those. Need some spots on. This is where I need the binos, man. KV1, don't go too far back, because if you do, I'm going to die. Like, literally get mugged off by a DW2, a KV1. Another KV1, I think it was. Oh well, there's little I could do about that, to be honest, other than fall back myself, but I don't know, could I have done something different? I could have fallen back even further, but I mean, there's five tanks down there, so as soon as they get within a reasonable range, because none of them, well, some of them are going to stop, some of them aren't going to stop. You can see I'm in very little cover. Look at that, I mean the flak buff's just flat sides everywhere. But to be fair, to be really honest, if I'd have had the binos, I think that would have been a totally different story. I think I would have pushed them back, held them there, and, well, what I mean is I would be able to spot them, therefore I'd be always been shooting them, and then they wouldn't have want to come out, and they wouldn't have advanced so quickly, so easily, without me spotting them. And they're on a rampage. Oh, the Crusader has woken up. Oh, thanks very much. They're sat in the camp. What am I talking about? They're sat in their camp. Go on, win us the game. Oh my, we're actually going to win it? Unbelievable. Go Crusader. I love the turret on this thing. It's kind of really coolly sloped. I can't believe it. We're actually going to win this game. Through the actions of that Crusader and that KB, that is awesome. Nearly did.
Mission accomplished.
Wow. Sweet as. 706 XP, 1000 damage. It's not too bad, is it? Not too bad at all. I did get that bonus of 200 XP though, so 250 XP. So that's one of the reasons. Right. So for me, I personally think it's going to be pretty critical that I'm going to get myself the binos. As far as I can work out, well, let's see how many games I reckon I'm going to have to play until I get to the Nashorn. 21,000. So I reckon 21,800. Let's not forget the 800. I reckon I'm going to have to play at least 22 more games on this. At least. And as I kind of average about 6 games an episode, that's a long time. So I need to up my XP game as much as possible. And at the moment, 60% win rate, that's not bad. That's not bad at all. I mean, I think most people would take that, wouldn't you? But in order to increase the XP, I've got to increase the spotting, I've got to increase the damage, I've got to increase everything. And the only way that I could conceive to do that, other than just spamming primo rounds like it's Christmas, is to get myself the binos. So I need to gain 350,000 silver as quickly as I can. Which means I am going to go and play all my other friendly tanks. And and they should get me some cash as soon as possible. So I'll leave it there and say thank you very much. I hope you enjoyed the flak bus. It's getting this gun is definitely an improvement. I just need to do a few more tweaks to get myself some awesomeness, and hopefully I'll be on the Nashorn before we know it. So thank you so much for watching. Please like and subscribe if you want to see more, and hopefully I'll see you in the next episode. Take care now.